this is coming to an end. Stuff like this is fun for a while, and then I get to a point where I just want it gone. Let's talk about what's left to do, and then do it and be done.
Let's review, shall we? Oh my goodness. Well, okay. Disclaimer. I'm going to say 1, 2. I don't know. I think most of these are broken in some respect. You'll never find knobs like this ever again. And let me just find something and show you. This is an example of the type of potentiometer that is inside that guitar. You can see the tiny little skinny shaft, which gets compressed and bent over because that set screw there gets over tightened in the wrong spot. Right? If we look really close, you can see it's got a split, but it's also got a flat side. So if you misalign that and you crank the screw, it breaks the shaft. And that's why those ended up getting glued back on. Finding pots like this, even if the knobs were still not wrecked because they filled all the one that fell off, they've just blobbed glue in the back of it and back on top. So this is fragile. But hey, give it the... Sounds quite nice.
I want to get this in the camera without too much glare. You can see the old shadow where the bridge had been placed forever. Well, that's how much the intonation was off. It's set where it needs to be now. Remarkably enough, the string action is quite acceptable. There's a little more neck relief than I'd like, but because it's such a short scale, it's very, very slinky. So it plays really easily. We need to adjust the nut here at the E string, so I've measured. But the biggest issue, and once again, hey, you know why I don't cut those? I'll tell you why, because I got to take all the strings off. With these old guitars, and I've lived this before, this is got three big ugly screws in there. When you put the neck back on, it kind of makes the frets and the fingerboard sometimes go a little wonky. So I need to do a little bit of fret leveling from the body joint to the end of the guitar, to the bridge pickup, but in this direction, to create a little bit of fall away. There's a couple little humpy frets. The G and the D string are the most problematic, but we're not going to fight with a couple frets at a time here. We're just going to gently level everything from there back to the neck pickup. Wait for me. I've shown this hack before. The nut was not glued in place yet, so a capo really was not my friend. So I just use that. Works great. And everything doesn't get all tangulated. That's going to solve it. Let's clean those up, recrown them, and shine the scrapes off them. And I think, what's left? Oh, I got to glue the nut in, and I do have to adjust a nut slot or two.
Great success. Get my fat fingers in between the frets. What's left? Glue in the nut and shave down one saddle slot. Well, after closer examination and a little more measuring, and let it sit, you know, let it sit, because it's only been sitting around for nearly 60 years. Oh, we're gonna have to adjust the string height at the bridge by adjusting the slots. This is doing everything it can possibly do to put the strings where they should be. So I like that one, I like that one, I like that one. That one, no, we don't like that one. The two E-strings don't like where they're at, so we're gonna fix that. This is really just, here's how you do it. Because it's very difficult to measure how much I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna take the file. I'm gonna go Maybe not even, maybe Put the string back on and measure. Cross your fingers. Hey, I didn't screw it up, but I gotta do the other E string. Which means I gotta find something else. A different file. I'm over here, don't worry. You're getting it, it'll happen. I might have to pause the camera. Someone's been in here mixing up my stuff again. What could go wrong? Close enough for rock and roll. Oh, where do we end up? I like it. I'm not gonna touch it. Well, you need tiny little fingers to play this, I must say. It is a pretty sounding thing. I wouldn't play with those controls. Be nice to it. And the real question is why? Okay, well, I'll do a little segment here and explain why. Two great examples of why. This guitar came out of the garbage. Okay, it plays, it does everything it does. I'd never do a gig with it, but it does inspire me to play, and it sounds pretty cool. Another example, once again, not without issues. I bought it, geez, how old is it now? It's old. It was like 10, 12 years old when I bought it. It's from the same era, 60s. It needed help. Took me a long time to find the right tuner plates and stuff. And then it needed to be rewired. But once again, very inspirational. A lot of fun to play. I'd fool around with it as a recording machine. And I think that the guy over there on the bench is the same thing. It's going to be what it's going to be if you don't break it anymore. So now I'm going to cut off the strings. And I'll let the guy know that he can have his guitar back. And if it had not been for a generous donation by a viewer, if he wants to say who he is, he can. I'm not gonna give out anybody's secret identity. And the guy that bought it, and he actually called me and thanked me. Because if it hadn't been for my video exposing how messed up this thing was, they might have given him a really hard time more than they did. But anyway, he did get some money back. So all in all, with my charitable donation of spending way too many hours on this, and I should just maybe... remind everybody, all the great links to things are below in the description if you care to become part of my world. But we'll go back through it. Fingerboard was separated from the neck. The nut and the nut slot and everything was a total mess. Tuner bushings were missing. Loose selector switch. Bridge had crumbled and disintegrated over time. We also discovered that some of these knobs are pretty fragile, and I really like, if you can see in the, like, more than one of them are all cacti'd, and it's back to what I was explaining earlier. What's happened,
right?
Okay, well, just one more time, get right in here. The pots that are in there are just like this. Okay, they've got a flat side and they're split. So what the person has done is turned that set screw against the split and squashed it, and in this case broken that little piece off, and then they glue it back on. So that's kind of sad. What else? Nothing really. That's it. It's over. Thanks for hanging out. Cheers, folks.